Many of us even know a friend or relative who has sadly been seriously injured or lost their life from an unguarded PTO. Most of us know that it is the most dangerous part on a tractor, and it is critical that you guard your PTO to prevent any serious injury or harm. Today, at SpareX, we're going to be talking to you about guard lock and why it's not only important to be on your PTO, but how convenient and easy it is for you on your farm and your tractor. SpareX's guard lock is a market-leading PTO guard. It's easy to fit, durable, and approved to the latest regulations. And we are now seeing some OEMs use and invest in the guard lock technology. Now, let's head to the back of our tractor and show you how to fit guard lock. One of the key features which SpareX prioritised when designing guard lock was the ease of application. You won't need to remove or potentially lose any grease nipples when applying guard lock, nor will you have to use any tools. With every guard lock that you get comes a selection of rings, offering more flexibility and coverage for your PTO shafts. Just before we carry on, let's really quickly show you how to measure your PTO shaft so you can get the correct guard. First up, we need to compress and close our PTO shaft. We then need to measure from the center of each UJ, and this will give us our LZ length, which is used on our website for all our PTO shafts. So if we get our tape measure and measure from the center of UJ to UJ, we can see that our PTO shaft is 1,000 millimeters, meaning when we go onto the website, we can look for that LZ length. If you can't find the exact size of LZ length for your PTO shaft, we always recommend purchasing longer and cutting the guard down. Next up, we need to measure the bearing so that we can get the correct ring size from our bag of rings, which comes with our guard lock guard. We're going to measure the bearing using a vernier. We then need to find the correct sized ring for our bearing. We have grabbed the correct size ring from our bag of rings, which comes with guard lock, and place this onto the PTO shaft as well. We can now slide our guard onto the white ring. And all we need to do is place our A-lock clasp over the bearing. Now we've added the guard to the implement side, we can do the exact same thing on the tractor side. Now we've fitted our guard lock to our PTO shaft, we can now grease up the UJs. We simply grab a flathead screwdriver, lift the A-lock clasp. We can then pull our guard lock back, which exposes the UJs for inspection and greasing. Now we've greased the UJs, we can now slide the guard back in place over the rings, and then simply put the A-lock clasp down and press into place. And that is guard lock now fitted to your PTO shaft.